This is probably the first of many leaf-inspired tiaras I'm going to make. It ended up as a bit of a cross between an elven tiara and a laurel wreath. I didn't want this tiara to have an overly dramatic shape, so I drew gentle curves with a little peak at the front. After playing with my wire for a bit, I measured out about 60 centimeters of 2 mm wire. I found the middle of the wire and I used my blunt nose pliers to make the peak. The wire gets shaped with the pads of my fingers. The shallow curves take a little bit of fiddling to get right. I wrapped the tiara base around my trusty Pyrex jug. I have got to remember to put this upside down when I'm doing this, it's really fiddly otherwise. There we go. Nope, still fiddly. I counted out my leaf charms. I ended up using 24 charms in total, 12 on each side. It took me a while to pick the charms for this. These have a nice shine and the raised detail catches the light as you move. I wrapped some 0.4mm wire onto the peak. Once the wire was secured, I started adding the leaf charms. I tried stringing the charms onto the 0.4mm wire and then twisting the wire to make little stems, but I found that the charms moved around way too much. I ended up stringing the charms onto the wire and then wrapping the wire around the base of the charm. I kept wrapping until the charm stayed in place. Every now and again, I attached a new piece of wire and kept adding the leaf charms. To finish, I wrapped the 0.4mm wire tightly around the base for about 1cm. Then I clipped off the excess and tucked in the ends. Then the leaf charms get added to the other side. I went through my bead collection to try and find something to add some sparkle to this tiara. I ended up picking some 4mm shiny green glass beads. I attached some more 0.4mm wire between two of the leaves. The beads are then twisted onto the wire to make little sprigs. There are 2 to 3 beads per sprig. I ended up with 12 little sprigs dotted around the tiara. This probably would have looked better with more sprigs, but I ran out of that colour of bead, so it is what it is. I measured 26 centimeters from the center of the tiara and then I clipped the ends of the wire. The ends are filed down and rolled into loops with the largest part of my round nose pliers. Thank you. I measured out 2 20-centimeter lengths of chain. I added a jump ring to the end of each chain. The loops at the end of the tiara get opened up and the jump ring on the chain gets slid into place. Last things last, I made a little S-bend hook with my round nose pliers to hold the chains in place. This turned out exactly as I imagined. It makes me want to make a flowy green forest fairy costume. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, please like and subscribe.